everybody, the Banga's back. Welcome to part 9 of Let's Play Yu-Gi-Oh! World Championship Tournament 2004, brought to you by GameAnyone.com. Okay, I think instead of going random, I'm gonna stick to battling, like, the Tier 2 opponents. I haven't dueled Rex in a while, why not go back to him? For now, at least. Okay, let's see how I'm gonna start this off here. And looking like Skelangle will be a very good choice. That way I can get to draw one card whenever it's flipped. Ooh, two out of King Rex. This could be an issue. Then again, I got Whiptail Crow. So I should be safe. Unless I'll get one new card. Ooh, seven colored fish, even better. Alright then, I'll use that instead. Do I have anything better, though, like a Gemini Elf? No, I don't. Alright, then, seven colored fish, take this guy down. No, I don't want to play the graceful dice. Because I'm not in any dire straits. Yet, at least, and I hope never to be anytime soon. But I guess if I undergo no adversity whatsoever, it wouldn't be an exciting Let's Play, would you agree? I would agree. Sometimes you need a little adversity to make a moment, or two, or three, or more. Ugh. Gate Deeg? That's what you're gonna do? Okay, fair enough. You got a very slim lead, though. Okay, so given the circumstances, it looks like Whiptail Crow it is. Still not going to be using the Dark Hole. I'd rather save that for when I'm really outnumbered, and I have no monsters I would want to save. Or better yet, no monsters at all. There, retaking the lead. Looks like we're going tit for tat here, the way it's going. That's all? Well, I guess the momentum's in my favor now. The way it's going. Game of that. I mean, of course I'd be game, because I'm the one benefiting from it. Like, I'm game with, like, being up against a wall and probably gonna lose. It's not like I wanted to win anyway. There we go. If you hear something going on in the background, chances are that's Lola cleaning herself right by my legs. Yeah, just a little reminder that, yeah, she's licking herself. If only I can get the ladies to do that, but then again, they'd have to be super flexible. Anyways, let's move on here. Okay, I don't really have anything that spectacular to use. I would like to bring in Blue Eyes White Dragon, but then I do no damage. So I'm thinking I'm just gonna flip summon Honey Honey. Alright then. Now I should be able to get one attack in. Ha, turtle raccoon. It's not a turtle, it's not a raccoon. It's a bit of both. But it looks like it's mostly raccoon. It's just like a raccoon with a shell on its back. That's it. No wonder it's called the raccoon last. But who's counting? Okay, I should be able to win on this turn, which I'm very proud of. Makes things a little easier for me. Yes, definitely this one. No chain. Okay, yeah, I should be able to win, but let's speed it up with a graceful dice. Three? Okay. That's an extra 900 attack points all across the board. And I got a text message. I won't answer that yet, but I will later, I promise. Alright, another easy win. I'm very proud of that. Honey Honey never got to attack, but eh, that's okay. He did his job. At least I think that's a he. Okay, Black Skull, I'm counting on you. Sangha of the Thunder! Ooh, that could be a very good card. Reduce the attack an opponent's monster attacking this card to zero. Well, that's good if you know you're going to be dealing with a heavy hitter. Otherwise, it just wouldn't attack at all. And I still don't have Weevil unlocked. So why don't we go with Esperoba here. Okay, you got the first turn. Fine by me. That'll give me time to answer this text message. Ah, tenderness. Okay, my move. So there was no face down card. Alright then, that's fine by me. Mechanical Chaser, get in there. And I'll have my Imperial Order ready in case this guy's got a Regeki or a Dark Hole in tow. And I'm pretty sure he does. Gotta be prepared, you know. And that's what I'm doing. But then Imperial Order would also negate my Monster Reborn. I'll have to make do, though. Yep, definitely activating it right now. I just don't understand. If you know your first spell got negated, why would you bother to do another one? Fine, do it then. I don't care anymore. You're just gonna make it so easy for me. Alright then, I'm guessing the turns for Swords Revealing Light do not actually count because the effect is not active. If that's the case, as soon as Imperial Order is gone, the Swords Revealing Light will be active, and then I'll just go three whole turns. I could be wrong, though, but we'll see. And that's it? Alright then. Yep, I'm still gonna pay it. Let me take a look at Swords Revealing Lights. Is it still at zero turns? One turn passed. Okay, so the turns are still being counted. That means Swords Revealing Lights can be unused and still be destroyed after three turns. Alright, that works in my favor for sure. It's costing me life points, but he's gonna be hemorrhaging more than I'm losing. As long as I keep up the offense, I'm going to do just fine. Still wish I actually did have, like, that trap card I had in my practice file, which was Needle Wall. And by practice file, I mean on my actual GBA cartridge, which I still have. Like, of course, I mean, they play, like, as much as Pharaonic Guardian as far as the booster packs go that were released in North America. Like, you get Legacy of Darkness and Pharaonic Guardian cards as well, which is pretty good. I think that my best Pharaonic Guardian card that I ever got was probably Moisture Creature. That's a very powerful card, if you manage to get one. With that said, I think it's time to go with a full Blitz. Oh, Macallion. Alright, so good thing to know that's not a Mirror Force. Otherwise, I would have shat bricks. And I really don't want to do that because that would be painful. Anyways, another win in the books, if I say so myself. Alright. Another Black Skull Dragon, please. Ooh, Magician of Faith. That's a good one. You know what? You're definitely going in my deck. Alright, let's make some changes here. What exactly is not going to serve me well at all? I think in the grand scheme of things, my Faith Bird will probably serve me the least. I think it'd be a lot easier if I filter through my effect monsters. Magician of Faith, there you are. What are my spells again? I'm pretty sure. Yeah, Dark Hole. Definitely worth keeping. Graceful Dice, Monster Reborn, new spell, Pot of Greed. Heavy Storm, Force of Century, Mystical Space Typhoon. Forceful Sentry is still serving me well, even though it's only one card. I still prefer to get Delinquent Duo later. Aha! We finally got Weevil Underwood unlocked! Okay, he likes to use Insects, Attack 3, Defense 2, Strategy 4, Intellect 3, and Luck 2. Alright, I'm ready for ya. Oh, I guess I get to go first. Awesome. Somewhat. I usually like to go second because I want to get the first crack of the damage. Okay, Pot of Greed activating right now. I mean, I've learned from my past mistakes that sometimes I like to save Pot of Greed for later, and then I get comments saying, oh, what's the point of that? Wouldn't it be better just to get the cards right now? And I'm fully understanding why they say that. It does make perfect sense in the grand scheme of things. Ooh, three face down cards. That could be a problem. But they should all be taken care of with Heavy Storm. Yeah, I think I'm better off just using Heavy Storm. Let's go for it. Because I have no idea what those three traps are. They could all be useless traps, I have no idea. Trap Hole, Call the Haunted, Mirror Force. Good! Got rid of them all. I think I'm gonna use a Whiptail Crow instead. Because chances are Weevil does use Maneater Bugs in his deck. And I think he also has Needleworm, which I remember as being an absolute pain in the ass. Okay, Fury Seeking. Because if a Needleworm is flipped, I mean, I lose 5 cards off the top of my deck and they go straight to the graveyard. They could be terrible cards, but they could also be great cards. That will burn me in the long run if I keep losing them. Alright, your move. Huh, just a face down card, okay. Doesn't seem to be hitting hard. Wolf Axe Wielder? I had no idea you were still in my deck! I'm gonna save you for later, though. First, let's go with Man Eater Bug. Face down. Like you show me yours, I show you mine. Oh, Kaganinjin, or Kaganingin? Yeah, it's one of those Japanese cards. Just remember, this game only releases, what, like, over 1,000 of the first Japanese cards, not exactly the North American ones, so to speak. I mean, that's what it is, the Japanese cards. I think it's around 1,200 or 1,300. I have no idea how many cards there were in Japan up to, like, Pharaonic Guardian. Who knows? Anyways, time to activate that Maneater Bug on this monster, of course. Oh, that was an effect monster! That was a lucky time to use it! Needleworm! I was worried about that! Okay, now it's time to swing for the fences in a big way. I don't think I'll have enough to win, but if anything, I'll be close. So let's just make the most of it. Go. Unfortunately, I have to deal with, like, asking if I want to activate Mystical Space Typhoon every phase. I mean, we gotta deal with it. And that's part of the rules. Okay, Weevil is very close to being defeated. He only has 1,300 more life points left. Okay, so one more turn should do it. Provided it's not one that completely shanks me. And he can do it. Probably not with that card, though. I don't think one card's gonna make a world of difference. Now it's time to take this guy down, once and for all. I mean, look at this lineup. He has no chance. It's over for him. You're just gonna take one? Well, I guess it doesn't really matter for you, so you might as well just give up. Alright, again, no. Alright, I win again! Now let's see, I think I wanna go with, Blackluster Soldier Pack. Again, I don't like using rituals, but I do need to get Mako Tsunami unlocked. And I think I did it. No, I didn't! Okay, I was a bit surprised on that. Let's go with Bones again. I think to unlock the level 3 tier opponents that I have to get, what was it? 5 wins on each level 2 opponent. And not only that, I also gotta get certain cards. Like, for example, when it comes to My Valentine, I need to get a Harpy Lady. When it comes to Joey Wheeler, I think I need a Jinzo? Could be wrong, though, but I'm pretty sure I'm right. Imperial Order, Widespread Ruin. And this is the guy that likes to use traps a lot? Bitch, please. Alright, Stone Armadillo, you're gonna go down. That's a Mirror Force, I'm not worried, because I also have my own traps. Magic Cylinder. Okay, that's the part that worried me. That's a lot of life points gone. Oh, I was hoping you'd bring in Summon Skull, but you didn't. No, not Widespread Ruin, Trap Hole. Of course, you put it in defense mode. Smart move. It's not gonna matter, boy. It's not gonna matter at all. Mechanical Chaser, baby. Alright, let's do this. I think this will be the last duel I have in this video. I don't want to stretch the videos out too long. But at least I'm getting a meaty amount of duels in each vid, provided who I'm facing. Like, maybe an average of 3, maybe 4, if they're too easy. That's not bad. If it's a very tough opponent, 1 is satisfactory. Because at least it'd be a great duel to watch. Unless I do something absolutely stupid, which can happen. Which has happened, actually. Alright, but I'm not gonna do anything stupid here. I managed to expose that Magic Cylinder right away, which is good. So we got that heavy hitter out of the way. He doesn't really have much means to protect himself. He doesn't have any spell cards in his graveyard. So that Magician of Faith is worthless. Alright, so far so good. I'd say one more turn, he's done. I don't care if you have any big spells in your hand, I got my Imperial Order to back me up. What you got, boy? Come on, what you got? What you got? You got nothing. Absolutely nothing. You're pathetic. And, yeah, since you like to use zombies, huh? Here's some poetic justice with my own zombie. It's not exactly great defense-wise, but hey, it gets the job done. Arlone, whatever. Not worried about that. And I think it's time Dragon Zombie got the finishing blow. There. And you are finished. Okay, I say one more Blackluster Soldier Pack and I should be able to get Mako unlocked. Okay, Novox, Prayer, Beastly, Mirror Ritual, Magician of Black Chaos, Black Illusion Ritual, and Zero Ritual. Okay. Okay, I do have Mako unlocked. Good. Big Wave, Attack 4, Defense 2, Strategy 2, Intellect 1, Luck 3. I believe this guy does have 7 colored fish and giant red sea snakes, so I can justify why he has an attack of 4. So in the next part, we're gonna take him on for the first time. Goodbye, everyone. Thanks for watching.